Benny liked attention, especially at the lunch table at school. He would drink milk and shoot it out his nose. He would eat everyone's beets. Once, he even dumped mashed potatoes on his head. Everyone thought Benny was gross, but they loved to watch him do stupid things. And Benny loved that they loved to watch, so every day he did something stupider and stupider. Then one day, he came up with his best idea ever, to put a bean up one nostril and shoot it out the other. So he stood on his chair and yelled, "And now the great Benny will do his greatest trick ever!" Everybody turned and looked at him. So he stuck a lima bean in his left nostril and then blew really hard to shoot it out the right one. But it didn't come out. He blew, and he blew, but the bean didn't come out. Benny was a little worried. Everyone started to laugh. Where had the lima bean gone? The next day, Benny felt a little scratch in the back of his throat. But when he opened his mouth, he couldn't see anything. The next day, it was worse. So he went to see the school nurse. "See? Aw." But she couldn't see anything either. Day after day, his throat got scratchier and scratchier. Until one day, he was at lunch and he coughed. And what came out of his mouth? The end of a bean sprout. He reached in his mouth to yank out the bean sprout, but it wouldn't come out. Benny ran to the nurse. She said she had never seen anything like this. So she got a pair of pliers and yanked and tugged and tugged and yanked, but the sprout would not budge. The nurse didn't know what else to do, so she dialed 911 and the ambulance came immediately. When Benny got to the hospital, they took an x-ray of his head and found that the lima bean had sprouted, and there were millions of sprouts all around his brain. The doctors decided to do emergency brain surgery, but once they got inside his head, they found that the bean sprouts had lodged so deeply in poor Benny's brain that if they would have tried to remove them, they would have killed him. So they just sewed Benny's head back up. Day by day, Benny got worse and worse. First, he had to quit school because he forgot how to talk, then how to walk, then how to eat, and finally, he forgot everything he ever knew. So now, Benny just sits at home like a vegetable, a big, giant vegetable, a human bean. People come from miles around to see Benny, the bean-headed boy. And now Benny gets all the attention he could ever want.